all dark, right up the plastic weather. Discussing governments, I take my time. I'm not the forward thinker. You read my mind, better to leave it unsaid. Why can't I leave it unsaid? You don't know.
What's going on, Element? Yeah!
All right. How are you guys doing tonight?
Oh, come on.
Oh, come on. You
that
can do better
weak,
than
that.
Weak.
What's going on, Element? Yeah!
Yeah. All right. That's better.
That was good.
That was a lot better.
Are you guys excited for School Wars?
Oh, man. They're ready.
All right. Now this is it. All right. Where's Timberland at? Timberland.
We got any Holt people? Holt in the house? Okay. I see you.
All right. Where's Liberty at?
We got one right here.
One person. Woo! All right. What about New High School?
All right. This one's good. Any homeschoolers in the house? All right. Okay.
Homeschool.
You're homeschool?
Oh, yes. You can tell by the socks. Look at those.
Oh, yeah. Nice socks. You guys seeing those?
All right. So it's going to be a great night. We got a couple of challenges going on. Are you guys ready to play some games?
All right.
Everyone, welcome out. Bowden.
Everybody, welcome Bowden.
All right.
So, we're going to need one boy and one girl from each school.
All right, one boy and one girl from each school.
So you pick the girls.
Let's go Timberland.
Timberland. Wesley, Timberland girl.
Timberland girl.
I need a Timberland
Who's
boy.
A Timberland? Okay, everyone's pointing
Timberland.
Her. All right. What?
I need a Timberland boy. Her. Timberland.
I guess she's coming
Timberland
up.
Boy.
All right.
Are you going to Timberland?
What just happened?
Hi, welcome
Timberland.
Back
Timberland, is there any middle school or high school boy that's going to Timberland? Right
Timberland
there. Come on.
We need a Timberland
Come
boy.
Come on. Yeah.
There we go.
Who All is right. that guy? Who I, is he?
I know, right? All right. What school now?
Come around, guys. You can come around.
The new school.
It's okay.
You already got a girl for Timberland.
We got a girl for Timberland. The new school. North Prairie.
All right. We need a
You're
boy
good.
And a girl
All right, boys on this side.
That is going
this
to go to
same,
the new high
the
school.
Side.
What is it? A boy and a girl that's going to North Point. Wesley? You already went to high school. All right, do you want to get a girl that or a boy that's going to North Point?
Boy from North
the
Point?
The new school.
I need a girl from North Point. You're going
is
to North Point?
Is there a boy
Point?
From North Point? Is
Are
that you?
Going to the new high school.
I can't
All
see.
Right, get on up here.
Yeah?
We need a boy. A
yeah,
boy.
I got it. Yeah,
All
come
right,
on.
A boy and a girl from New High School,
we got
North
this.
Point.
All right.
What?
So we got our contestants for the first game.
Yes. All right.
All right. So this first game.
All right.
This first game is going to be wild. Y'all ready? You paying attention? Guys, all right. So what we're going to do, your teammate is going to get a mouthful of water and gargle, hum, sing a song that we tell them. And your teammate has to guess what it is. Do you understand?
Did you guys hear that?
So your teammate is going to get a mouthful of water and gargle hum
so they have
a song,
to hum a
and you have
song
to guess what it is. Okay?
With a mouthful of water,
so
and their teammate
who on your
has
team
to guess
is
going to
gargle
is.
And hum. She's not doing it. He's not doing it. All right, well, you guys are out. You got scissor, paper, rock, war. Are you guys at Timberland?
I'm going to Timberland.
Okay, cool.
All right.
Scissor,
so
paper,
pretty
rock.
Much what this game is.
Scissor, paper, rock.
Is they're going to have a mouthful of water and they have to hum a song, and their teammate
one,
has to guess
one.
What song it is. I think this could go really bad. What
All
happens?
Right. You are gargling
what would happen
and
if like they like
Who won?
Laughed and like spewed water in their face?
You are gargling
Am I supposed
and
to hold it to
win?
Their throat
no,
while they
are.
Do this?
Yeah. Gargling and humming. Gargling and humming.
I don't know.
Right. Is that how Here's it's supposed
water.
To look?
Here's
I think so. That looked great.
So you have to tell them what the song is because my mic is right here.
All right. All right. So who's gonna be humming? Who's Shit. Humming?
Yeah. You got.
Who's
be quiet.
Oh yay! This is gonna be fun.
All right.
We'll have a facing. Yeah.
Yep. Take your water. Get your water.
So you gotta
water.
Hold the water in your mouth.
And gargle and hum it.
Here.
All right. Who do you think's gonna no. win? North Point or Timberland?
More,
North Point
more,
or Timberland?
Gargle and hum. All right. You ready?
I don't know.
Are you ready? Scoot
right.
up so they can hear you.
Let's hear it.
All right. Go.
Don't
here,
spit it
on,
out.
Warm. What song is he humming? What song is he humming? Hold the mic up. Listen to him. What song is he humming? What song is he humming? Oh, you didn't tell him?
Yes. Listen closely.
We got it. Yes, we got it.
All right, we got it right here.
It was the national anthem.
The national anthem.
All right.
All right. So that means
Timberland advances.
Timberland advances. You guys can go. Have a seat. Thank you very much.
Yeah, good job, Timberland.
Hey, North Point, thank you guys so much. You go. Yeah. Have a seat. Thank you. All right. What now? Who's
so
next?
Actually, I think we need the Timberland boy and girl to stay back up.
Oh,
here.
Timberland
boy
and girl.
Oh, wait. Never mind. Stay back up. Stay back up.
So we need a boy and a girl from Liberty.
Liberty. All right. I need a boy and a girl from Liberty. Liberty High School. You go to Liberty or you will be going to Liberty.
Liberty.
Yeah, will you get a girl from Liberty?
Girl from Liberty?
And I need a guy. A guy that goes to Liberty High School. Or will be going to Liberty.
Is there any girls from Liberty? Is there any girls from
You're
Liberty?
You're going to go to Liberty High School?
You're not a girl.
Do you want to? Joel, we need you.
Ashley!
Joel, we need you.
Ashley, come on.
Let's go, Joel.
Oh, gosh, everyone's stepping on the lights.
Yes.
All right.
We need a boy and girl from Hope.
A boy and a girl from Hope?
Yes.
We got brother, sister power.
That's beautiful.
Right? Aren't you proud? Proud, dude.
We're going to have two games going at once right here. The same
all
game.
Right. All right.
So, Hope. We need Hope.
We need Hope. Hope.
I get a boy. Wow. A boy from Hope.
Wow.
A boy from Hope.
A girl from Hope.
Hold up.
A girl from Hope.
Hold up. I'm looking all around. I'm looking all around.
Get on up here. Girl from Hope.
A boy
there
from
go.
Hope.
There we go. I got one.
Right there. Right there. No?
Here.
Oh, my gosh.
All right. Girl from
Hope.
Yeah,
yeah, yeah. All right. Come on up.
Y'all are crazy. Do we got him?
Yep. Right here. There's Hope. Here's Liberty.
Where's the young man?
Where'd he go? There he is.
All right. So now we're going to need two contestants from a school we have not yet named. So, like Fort Zumwalt, Francis Howe,
all, right.
all the extra schools, Christian.
So we need somebody from a Fort Zumwalt, a Central, or a Francis Howell, or homeschool. One of those three.
I got the boy.
All right, I'll get the boy.
I need a girl. Wow. I need a girl.
Tommy.
I need a
Tommy.
Girl.
Tommy!
Oh,
Tommy!
Man.
Come on!
I need a girl!
Come on!
I need a girl!
Tommy, come up! Okay.
I need a girl. What school do you go to?
He wasn't on any Fort lights,
Zumwalt.
He's fine.
Get on up here.
So
right.
Who do we got? Do we got a boy?
Do we got everybody?
Yeah. So, hey, Fort Zumwalt West, you wanna come over here with Tommy? There
All
we
right.
go.
So All this right. is what the game is. This is a weird game. Y'all right. ready? Paying attention. Can you hear me? So you and your teammate are only allowed to use one hand each to fold
oh,
a paper airplane. And the first team
Ooh, that
folds a paper
difficult.
Airplane and flies it 5 feet wins and moves on
you
out of
can't.
Both teams.
Does anybody know how to make a paper airplane with one hand?
You got this?
Wow, so you're. I just was asking. You got it?
We've got the
Okay,
extra
well, if I ever need that, I'll
Timberland
ask you.
And Liberty versus Hulk.
Okay. So, Liberty and Holt, right over here. Liberty and
Holt.
Liberty, Holt. Liberty and Holt, right here.
Ashley and Joel, one hand to build the paper
Liberty
airplane
Holt,
each.
And then you need...
You two,
I need
let's
the Zumwalts.
Did you catch that?
And...
You and him each have
Timberland.
One hand to build the paper airplane.
Yeah.
You build it together, okay?
Do you know what, you know what the rules are? You have to build a paper airplane with one hand.
Together. Together. And it's got to fly 5 feet.
5 feet. All right. So in case you're wondering, the game is they have to use one hand to build a paper airplane that will fly 5 feet.
Wild.
5 feet. I don't. Do you think it's gonna be easy?
Huh? What was that?
Do you guys understand?
Do you think it's gonna be easy?
Oh yeah, of course.
Do you understand?
Do you think you can do it? I think
any questions?
Dude, we could do it.
Do you guys think like, we
got
should do it?
You got
it wouldn't be hard. Like, let's try
Wes
it midair.
Right. Hold on,
Wes and Brian, let's get this going.
And then,
fold.
Wes
and Brian.
No, wait. You fold. Why are you folding this
yep,
way?
Yep, and then,
fold.
And then we pick it up.
And then we
fly.
Are you guys ready?
Yes,
oh,
ready.
We are building.
3, 2, 1,
ready.
Let's go.
All right, on your mark.
Get set.
Go.
Where's my
right,
Timberland people
win?
At?
Cheer on your schools.
Timberland! Let me hear you!
Cheer on your schools! Come on, I can hear you! Cheer on your schools! Come on, let's go! Oh.
You guys got this!
Oh, Timberland!
Oh, that's a good folding right
Timberland's
here!
Timberland's doing really good!
Oh man,
oh, man.
This is that's not a plane! That's not
All
a
right.
plane!
Now fly it!
Yeah!
Wait!
Yes.
Timberland did it!
Timberland!
Timberland!
Timberland! Let's
go!
Who went over here? Who won on this
Liberty
side?
Liberty did.
Oh, Timberland, right? And what school is this?
Nice job, Timberland.
Timberland versus Liberty for the final.
Yes.
Thank you so much. Good try.
Thank you, guys.
Tommy, great job, right, buddy. Where's Timberland at?
Where's our Timberland people?
No.
All right.
You got another game.
Where's our Liberty people? Okay. All right.
So what Woo. Teams do we have? We have Timberland.
And Liberty.
And Liberty. Oh, man.
This is for the championship.
We have the Hively Power Duo. This is intense. Wesley, are you sweating yet?
Everywhere.
I'm profusely
sweating. I'm drenched in sweat. Gross.
So who do you think is going to win, Timberland or Liberty?
Oh, man, I'm Timberland all the way.
Timberland?
Yeah.
I mean, I think Liberty's going to take it. Personally. Where my Liberty people at? Yeah.
Timberland has gone 2-0.
All right.
We're going to make it 3-0 tonight.
So here's the deal. Here's the deal, guys. You guys have to each put a cup on your hand and work together and stack these two dices on top of each other. Does it make sense?
What?
So one hand, one person, one hand.
You have to stack the dice. Easy, we got this. All right, who thinks Liberty's gonna win?
Who thinks Timberland's gonna win?
Let's make some noise. Are you ready?
All right.
Are you ready?
Ready!
Let's cheer them on, guys. 3, 2, 1, go!
Yeah, go Liberty!
Timberland! 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 Timberland!
Liberty!
Timberland!
It just stayed! It just stayed!
They hit the table! Well, keep going, keep going.
It's gotta stay! It's gotta stay! Come on, Liberty!
They hit the table. Don't hit the table.
They got a chant going. I don't know any chants.
I don't know. They kept knocking the table.
What is this?
I guess, was that Liberty wins?
This is Liberty.
That's 2 out of 3. That's 2 out of 3.
They kept knocking the table. It didn't stay for but half a second. There's a still standing.
Yeah, there's clearly did it twice.
What? No.
Good job. Good job, Liberty. Good job. Good job. I love myself.
All right, give it up for Liberty, guys.
Liberty!
Good job, Liberty.
So we now know that Liberty is the best of the best high schools. Man, are you guys excited for the rest of the night? You guys are sound excited. It's going to be pretty great. We got a lot more fun stuff, right, Bowden?
Yes, sir.
Right on.
I got this. Thank you, sir. Love you.
No, you too.
All right, guys. In a couple more seconds, we are going to sing a couple songs to God. Because the first song we're going to sing, everybody heads up. Yo. I know you're all excited. I know we are excited. But we are getting ready to move into a time of worshiping God. So let's calm down just a little bit. Just a little bit. The first song we are going to sing tonight is called Brighter. And I know some of you guys may be in here tonight living in complete darkness. You may feel like there's no hope or there's just despair. But know this. Just because you came for some food or a chance at $10,000, God has an amazing plan for your guys' life. In Jeremiah 29:11, it says, "For I know the plans I have for you, says the Lord. They are plans for good and not for disaster, to give you a future and a hope." You see, guys, we sing to God because he loves each and every one of us, and he has an amazing plan for your lives. So no matter what you came in through these doors with carrying tonight, you just know you can lay it down at the feet of Jesus because he has an amazing plan for your guys' life. So let's get ready to worship.
What's up, Bellamy Youth? Come on down to the front. Let's get ready to worship. Thank you. enter into a time of worship right now. I just want us to sing out to the creator of the universe. I want us to sing out to Jesus Christ tonight and just realize what he has done for us. Let's just sing this out, the atmosphere. great and mighty of a God he is. He can pull us from the lowest of lows. He's in this place tonight with us. Even when life is hard, our God is still good.
There I find you in the midst.
now. You are His. We are His children. He loves each of you so much, and He has a plan for you, an amazing plan, and He has a message that you need to hear tonight. You are here for a purpose and a plan. God is over this whole room. He loves each of you so much. He's calling on to you right now in this place. Let's just lift Him up right now. Let's lift up the name of Jesus. We serve such a good God. Let's just praise Him in this place. We're going to have an amazing rest of the night, just worshiping and glorifying our Father. God, I just pray that You would stay here with us tonight, that You would stay with us for the rest of our lives, and I pray that just life change would happen tonight. We serve an amazing God. In Jesus' name, amen.
All right, guys. You all can be seated, please. Guys, right now we are going to continue worshiping God with our tithes and offering. And if this is your first time with us tonight, there is no pressure to participate. But if you would love to give of tithes and offerings, there are many different ways you can do that. You can give by text by texting the number on the screen. You can actually give on the Element Church app. You can go to elementchurch.com/give and make your tithes and offering there. Or as you leave the auditorium tonight, we will have a couple of offering buckets right outside. And we will also have one in the cafeteria over there as you guys get sodas and snacks and whatnot. But tonight, I wanted to go to 2 Corinthians 9:7. It says, each of you should give what you have decided in your heart to give, not reluctantly or under compulsion, for God loves a cheerful giver. You see, we're able to do events like tonight where we're able to potentially give away $10,000, give each and every one of you a cheeseburger because someone just like you cheerfully gave of their tithes and offerings. And next week, we're going to have an amazing event where we're going to give out more free food. And it is all because of people just like you being faithful to God with their tithes and offering. So as we think about that, let us just pray. Father in heaven, thank you so much for this opportunity to fellowship together, to have all our schools and friends here. Thank you for cheerful givers that we're able to take their offerings and use it and bless so many other people and just share the name of your son, Jesus. And it's in Jesus' name that we all said, amen.
Excited to be here? Man, I am so excited that you guys are here. Which one's the best school here? Which one's best represented? Unless you yelled South, you're wrong. I am repping my school. Thank you very much. West, you're terrible. I just had to say it. So anyways, you know what's funny? All right, here's something funny. All right, bring it down. Here's something funny. This jersey is older than every last one of you. That's funny. I've personally had this jersey for 15 years. So, yes, it's kind of crazy. It still fits, and that's just weird. When I put it on, I was like, hey, I haven't put on as much weight as I thought I did. So, anyways, moving on. How many of you have been here for any part of this series that we're in, Make War? How many of you have been here? All right. So we are in week 6. Yes, 6 weeks. I can't believe that I have had the attention span to stay in one series for 6 weeks, but we've done it. We've been looking at David and Goliath. How many of you have heard of David and Goliath? Yes. It is one of the most referenced Bible stories that there is. Even in the secular world, you watch a football game, and what do we hear? This is a true David and Goliath story, right? It's the underdog story. So we've been looking at David and Goliath. We started 5 weeks ago. I love how silence just like, it like freaks you guys out or something, because just be quiet up here and you guys are like, what's going on? So anyways, 5 weeks ago, we started off by looking at how just in every battle, there's two sides, right? In David and Goliath's story, there was the Israelite side, which is the children of God, and there were the Philistines, which are the enemy of God. They were on two hills with a valley between them. There is no one in the valley. In our lives, we have to choose a side. Are we going to be a child of God, or are we going to be an enemy of God? We can't say that we're going to be in the valley because the devil owns the valley. You can't be an indifferent person, because if you're indifferent, you're against God. So we saw that the first week. If you weren't here, we are on YouTube. We are also on, like I say, almost every week, we are on the old people social media called Facebook. And so you can go back, Element Youth MO. You can watch any of the services. 4 weeks ago, we followed up that first week by looking at how it's absurd for me to show you one picture. Remember, I showed you a picture of me and my wife when I was 19. We first started dating 13 years ago, and I looked like I was 10. And I tried to tell you that one picture showed the entire 13 years of our relationship, and it's absurd. But somehow, we think we can do that in our lives, where we take a giant from our past, we take a mistake that we've made, and we allow it to define us in the current day today, right? We like to say, oh, that decision I made 3 years ago, that decision I made before, that decision from my past, that is who I am. That mistake is who I am. There is only one who can define you, and that is Jesus Christ, your creator. And so if you did not see that, I encourage you to go back and watch that. Then we followed that up by looking at how a lot of us are stuck in life because we're too busy playing with the wrapping paper, and we're not actually enjoying the gifts that God has given us. Every last one of you is gifted. Most of you are not gifted at kickball, as we saw out in the parking lot. But all of us are gifted, and we're gifted for a purpose so that we can plunder hell and populate heaven. Hell is a real literal place, and unfortunately a lot of our friends, a lot of our school is heading there, and God gave you a gift in your life so that you can reach your school for him. So we talked about how we have to get unstuck by getting into our gifts. And then we looked at how there's a purpose to our problems, right? Our problems prepare us. They point us to God. And ultimately, our problems promote us. And then last week, we looked at two big decisions. The decision that you have to decide to be yourself. And you have to decide to take action. Showing up and sitting in a seat and listening to someone talk for 20 minutes is not going to change your life. Unless you make this faith, unless you make this journey your own, unless you make the decision to take action and walk with Christ, your life will be no different. And so that's what we looked at last week. This week is kind of a recap of all the weeks in one, and we are going to be talking about going all in. But first, let's pray. Father, I thank you for each and every person here tonight. Lord, I thank you that we can come and have fun, and we can have rivalries, and we can talk smack about the other schools. And God, that we can come into your house and we can smile. God, that you are not a cosmic killjoy sitting up in heaven with a list of rules because you want to kill all our fun. You enjoy when we enjoy life. And God, thank you that we can come into your presence. We can sing praises to your name and we can enjoy being around you. God, I pray that you would speak through me tonight, that each person in here would have open ears and that you would speak to them right where they are and you would impact their lives. In Jesus' name, everyone said, amen. Amen. We're going to start off with a little statement here, okay? Your now is the preparation for your next. Your now is your preparation for your next, because God won't give you what is next until you are faithful with what is now. God is not going to give you what is next in your life, what he has designed you for, until you are faithful with what he has given you right now in this moment. Your now is preparation for what is next. 1 Samuel 16, verse 11 says, "Then Samuel asked, 'Are these all your sons, or are these all the sons you have?' 'There is still the youngest,' Jesse replied, 'but he's out in the fields watching the sheep and goats.' 'Send for him at once,' Samuel said. 'We will not sit down to eat until he arrives.'" We looked at this a couple of weeks ago when we were talking about problems, and we talked about how David was in the pasture of his life, and some of you are here today and you feel completely lost. You feel like you are wandering through the middle of nowhere in your life. David was in that same exact situation. He was in the pasture. He was forgotten by his family. Samuel said, "Bring all your sons." Jesse brought all except for David. He was considered the youngest. He was the runt. He was insignificant. But see, what we see is pastures precede palaces. God has a palace designed for you. He has a purpose for you in your life. But sometimes that means walking through a pasture to get there. Psalm 23, verses 1 through 4 says, "The Lord is my shepherd. I have all that I need." That's so countercultural. Because, see, we like to say, "Well, I need that new video game. I need the PlayStation 5. I need new shoes. "The Lord is my shepherd. I have all that I need. He lets me rest in green meadows. He leads me beside peaceful streams. He renews my strength. He guides me along right paths, bringing honor to his name." Is the way that you're walking bringing honor to God's name? Just throwing that out there. "Even when I walk through the darkest valley, I will not be afraid. You are close beside me. Your rod and your staff protect and comfort me." Sometimes we think the darkness that we're in right now is the destination, but it's not the destination. It's the journey to your destination. God is leading you through the darkest valley to the palace that he has prepared for you. Pastures precede palaces. 1 Samuel 16, verse 12 and 13. "So Jesse sent for him. He was dark and handsome with beautiful eyes. And the Lord said, 'This is the one, anoint him.' So as David stood there among his brothers, Samuel took the flask of olive oil he had brought and anointed David with the oil. And the Spirit of the Lord came powerfully upon David from that day on. Then Samuel returned to Ramah. The second thing we see is that humility precedes authority. See, David was anointed to be king, but then he went back to the pasture. He went back to tending to the sheep. And we see in 1 Samuel 17 that one day Jesse comes to him and he's like, "Hey, I want you to take this food and I want you to go out to the battle lines to where your brothers are. This is the kid that was anointed king and now he is being asked to go serve his brothers." And he had an option, he had a choice. See, this was a moment in his life, much like where you're at, where he was a teenager. He didn't have much authority. I have authority. But see, God already had a plan for him and a purpose for him. And he had to choose to be humble, because humility precedes authority. If you're too big for the small things, you're too small for the big things. If you are too big to bend down and pick up a piece of trash and throw it away, you are too small to lead anything. If you are too big for the small things, you are too small for the big things. See, we don't have a leadership problem. Your generation is a generation of world changers. Your generation is one of the most influential generations ever. You do not have an influence problem. You have a pride problem. You think that because you have influence, that you're too big to do the small things in life. And if you are too big to do the small things, then you are too small to do the big things. As long as you live with pride, you will never be elevated to authority. Proverbs 16, verse 18 says, pride goes before destruction and haughtiness before a fall. For me, it looks like this, okay? I graduated high school in 2006. For those of you who are trying to do the math right now, that makes me 32 years old, okay? Lucky number. I graduated in 2006. I played football all 4 years of high school. I absolutely love football. And my freshman year, I was one of like 95 people on our team. Okay? My freshman year, we went 9-1. For those of you who don't know sports or don't care about sports, that means we won 9 games, we lost 1 game. We were pretty good. One of those games that we won was against Zumwalt West, and we destroyed them. For those of you who don't know, South and West are rivals, and we absolutely destroyed them. It was amazing. Sophomore year, we come back. Now the team is only like 35 people because 60 of them decided they didn't want to play anymore. I don't know where they went, but they just decided they didn't want to play anymore. So we're down to like 30-something. Once again, we go 9-1. Once again, we destroyed West. In this moment, both of these years, we destroyed them as freshmen, as JV, only to watch our varsity team receive the opposite treatment. Kind of sad. Junior year, we come in and we're all kinds of prideful, right? We're like, oh, we got this in the bag. We're already counting on state. We're already like, we're just the stuff because we went 9-1 in freshman and 9-1 in JV, and we're feeling good about ourselves. We come in and we go 3-7. Ouch. One of those 7 losses was to West. To be fair, the team we played against had 2 players that ended up in the NFL on that team. So, just saying. Okay, senior year we come back and we're still prideful. We didn't learn our lesson. We didn't humble ourselves. We're still walking around with a chip on our shoulder like we have it all together. And now it's totally flipped. We go 1-9, and the only game we won was against Troy because they're terrible. It's okay, I live in Troy. And unless we move, which I really hope we move because I want my kid to play for a good school, he will be playing for Troy. So, God has designed each and every one of you for victory in your life. You are not designed to go 1-9 in the standings of life. The only way, though, that you will experience the victory that God has for you is if you humble yourself. Because pride goes before destruction. 1 Samuel 17, verses 8 through 10 and verse 16 says, Goliath stood and shouted a taunt across to the Israelites. Taunting is so annoying. Unless you have a microphone and you're the one doing the... Anyways, Goliath stood and shouted a taunt across to the Israelites. Why are you all coming out to fight? He called. I am the Philistine champion and you are the servants of Saul. Choose one man to come down here and fight me. If he kills me, we will be your slaves. But if I kill him, you will be our slaves. I defy the armies of Israel today. Send me a man who will fight for 40 days. Every morning and evening, the champion, the Philistine champion, strutted in front of the Israelite army. For 40 days, he openly defied the children of God. He openly defied the one living God. David shows up and he hears this guy being completely brash and irrational. And here's David's response. In 1 Samuel 17:32 and 33, he says, "Don't worry about this Philistine," David told Saul. "I'll go fight him." "Don't be ridiculous," Saul replied. "There's no way you can fight this Philistine and possibly win. You're only a boy, and he's been a man of war since his youth." See, David was appalled by Goliath to the point where he had to do something. Sin is brash, but grace is bold. See, Goliath was walking in sin as he was defying God. But David in this moment knew that he was covered by the grace of God. He was able to walk in a boldness because he was covered by the grace of God. When you're living for yourself, you'll just be like Goliath. You'll be living brash. But we're not called to live brash. We're called to love our neighbor. You know, that doesn't mean that we are called to be tolerant. What? I can't believe he said that. Because culture today says you have to be tolerant of everything and everyone. No, David didn't come out and be like, "Oh, I'm going to tolerate him defying God." No, he took a sling and a stone and he drilled Goliath right in the middle of the forehead. Then, as we're about to see, he took Goliath's sword out of his sheath and cut his head off. He was not tolerant of the sin in his life. We need to stop sitting by silently and allowing culture to deteriorate, and we need to stand up for the truth that is in God's word. First Samuel 17, verses 50 and 51 says, "So David triumphed over the Philistine with only a sling and a stone, for he had no sword. Then David ran over and pulled Goliath's sword from the sheath. David used it to kill him and cut off his head." If you ever say the Bible is boring, you haven't been reading the Bible. "When the Philistines saw that their champion was dead, they turned and ran." I know in a room with this many students that there are a lot of you who feel like your life has been nothing but a battle. That there has yet to be even a single moment of peace and calm. Especially in 2020. The calm may not come until you commit. The calm may not come in your life until you commit. You might be that person who's here and feel like it's one battle after another battle after another battle. And can I just come up for some air? I'm sinking here. But you've yet to commit 100% of your life to following Jesus, living all in, unashamed. Forget what the world says. Two weeks ago, I found out that my best friend from high school is moving away. He's the only, out of over 500 people I graduate with, he's one person that I still talk to this day. One person. And he's moving away, so now I'm going to talk to him even less.
That's sad.
That is sad. You know what's even more sad?
What? You grew up with
What's even more sad is that if you're anything like me at your age, you live so consumed worrying about the people around you and what they think, instead of living what God thinks, instead of going all in, instead of committing, that you are putting yourself through battle after battle after battle. See, the problem is the people you hang out with today are probably not going to be in your life 10 or 15 years from now. And I know you're sitting there, you're like, no, me and my friend, we're BFFs. That'll never happen to us. Okay. Good luck. I hope that's true for you. And I hope that they are a Christian friend who's going to push you closer and closer to God. But like I said, I'm 32. I've talked with a lot of my leaders who are my age or around my age. And I'm not the only one who's in communication with one person from my high school or less. You might think, oh, I'm different. Stop worrying about the people around you and make a decision to commit. Because see, the only calm is found in Jesus. Matthew 11, verse 28 through 30 says, "Then Jesus said, 'Come to me, all of you who are weary and carry heavy burdens.'" I know I'm not naive to think, oh, you're teenagers, so you can't carry heavy burdens. I know that you guys have burdens that you're carrying. And Jesus is saying, "Come to him, and he will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you, let me teach you, because I am humble and gentle at heart, and you will find rest for your souls, for my yoke is easy to bear, and the burden I give you is light." Right now, with every head bowed, every eye closed, let's pray. Father, thank you for these students. God, thank you that you made a way for us to have a relationship with you. God, that we can go all in. And that, God, as we go all in, you will begin to change us from the inside out. God, we don't have to get all of our ducks in a row. We don't have to get everything in order to come to you. God, you have called us to come to you exactly how we are. God, thank you that you knew everything we would do, every decision we would make, and yet you still decided to send your son to earth to live a perfect life, to die on a cross, to be in the grave for 3 days and rise from the dead so that we could have a relationship with you. God, thank you for making a way where there was no way. With every head still bowed, every eye still closed, I want to give you an opportunity. Maybe you're in here and you've never accepted Jesus. Maybe this is your first time ever coming to a church, or maybe you're here and all you've ever known is a God who's mad at you, that you can never do anything right. That's not God. John 3:16 says, "For God so loved the world, that he gave his one and only son." Verse 17 says, Jesus didn't come into the world to condemn the world. God did not come to condemn you, but to save you. Tonight, maybe you're here and you've never heard about that Jesus, and tonight you want to start a relationship with him. You want to commit. You want to start walking with him. Or maybe you're here and it's been a while. You've made that decision, but you've wandered. You've gone off on your own. You've made your own decisions, and tonight you say, you know what? I need to come back. I need to rededicate my life to living for God. I need to go all in again. Tonight, with every head bowed, no one looking around, if that's you, if you're in either one of those situations in your life, I would ask, right where you're sitting, would you raise your hand? There are hands all over this room of students who are saying, that's me, I need to make that decision. I need to follow Christ, either for the first time, or I want to rededicate my life. I want to commit today. I want to go all in. I want to lead you in a prayer. And we believe in those who are making that decision. So I'm going to ask everyone in here to repeat this prayer as we support them. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, thank you for sending your Son to pay the price that I could never pay. Thank you that you loved me when I was unlovable, that you sent your Son to save me. Today I choose to follow you. Please forgive me of all my sins and make me brand new. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Can we celebrate those who made that decision?
Thank you, Pastor Jeff.
Can you hear me? Awesome. So if you guys made that decision for the first time or whatever time it was, and you want to know what your next steps are, come talk to one of our leaders. Talk to myself. Talk to Pastor Jeff. We would love to help you out and figure out what those next steps are. So who's ready to hear about next week?
I am. I'm ready.
I'm ready. I'm personally really excited.
I'm pretty excited. So I know we've got an amazing event planned for you all. It's called Homecoming. Brian West, can you tell us what we got going on?
So pretty much you find a date and then you get in the car and you go to your school and then you dance.
I don't think that's what that is.
No?
No, they canceled all those.
Oh, different homecoming.
This homecoming here.
Oh, you should.
This homecoming will have pizza.
Pizza, right?
Pizza Ranch.
Oh, yeah, it's going to be
pizza
good.
Pizza Ranch.
Is it free?
It's free pizza.
Free pizza.
From Pizza Ranch. But it's going to be amazing.
The most amazing thing, guys, is we are going to be back in the landing.
Yes.
It's going to be pretty awesome, right?
Yes.
It's going to be our own space. We're back where youth, we're going back home.
The homecoming.
We're going homecoming, just like Spider-Man.
Well, are we giving anything away next week?
Ooh, we are giving something.
You guys like free stuff, right?
Should I tell them?
Yes.
You want me to tell them?
They don't sound very excited. You guys like free stuff? All right.
So everyone who comes next week is going to get their name in a drawing for a Bluetooth record player.
What? Bluetooth record player?
It sounds weird, but it's like a record player, but it's also like a Bluetooth speaker. It's really dope.
Do I not have to plug it in?
No, you have to plug it in.
But like how's it? It's like,
you can play